Hello everyone, in today's video we will cover one functional topic which is relevant with vendor invoice. And normally there can be a process which is available in D365 which will allow you to post vendor invoices in batch. So there are certain configurational parameters and there is a certain setup which also need to be done before a vendor invoice is posted in batch. And that will basically facilitate when you have so many invoices in bulk and you need it to be posted in off-peak time or in automated fashion instead of posting manually. So I will just introduce you to few of the parameters which are available before you can do the batch posting of the invoices. So first of all, you need to go to system administration module, and there in the setup menu group you need to go to the initialize process automation or process automations. Basically you need to first check in process automation. If I will just show you, then you can go to the background processes which are available here, and you can note down here that vendor invoice batch posting process, which is a background process, is enabled here for all the companies, and it is enabled and repeats every minute. Repeat interval is there, and there is certain other parameters like when is the next execution, and the repeat interval is also given. So this need to be enabled. If it is not enabled, what you have to do is you need to go and initialize process automations. It will take a while and it will basically set up this vendor invoice batch posting, which is necessary for posting the vendor invoice in batch. So after this, then you also need to check in accounts payable parameters that is available. If you can collapse and you can go to the setup and then accounts payable parameters, and then invoice tab, you need to check here invoice workflow at the bottom. Number of invoices per batch allowed are 5 invoices per batch, and then there is a setting about hours before posting is rescheduled. So if some of the invoices is has not been run in the previous batch, so the next time it will be run after 12 hours. That is almost a midday. And then there is a frequency of background processing that is defined in minutes. Interval is defined 1 minute, so you can make change if it is necessary, like 5 minutes or 15 minutes, whatever settings suit you, your company or your business scenario, so you can do that. So these are the extra settings which need to be done. And then there are certain workflow which need to be enabled. So that is at least one workflow which need to be enabled is vendor invoice workflow, and the other one is for the approval hierarchy. And this vendor invoice workflow is basically having a task. I will just show you that will basically have the task of auto posting of the invoice. So let it open. So there is only a single node which will basically perform an automated task of posting the vendor invoice. That need to be enabled. So on the left hand side you can see automated task. Here post the vendor invoice using a batch that need to be dropped here, and a start node should connect to this automated task, post the vendor invoice, and then it should end. And additionally, if you want, you can also change the name, or if there are certain notification that need to be enabled when it is basically executed or canceled, that can be enabled. So that is based upon your specific requirements. So this workflow also need to be enabled in order to post the vendor invoice automatically. The other workflow is the normal invoice hierarchy workflow. Let me also show you that one. That depends upon your business scenario. If you want to enable that, it is up to your requirements. So basically, once that workflow is approved, means vendor invoice is approved, then automatically vendor invoice workflow will take it and it will post it. So the type is vendor process invoice of the automated posting of the vendor invoice. So this one is for approval, and I will just show you the inner node. Here it is having only a single node, and this is having an assignment to a user, and that is Sarah. So I will just assign it to my admin user. Go to level 1, just notes of version, activate the new version. Okay, so now we'll do one posting of vendor invoice. So for that I need to go to the all purchase order form. So I will just pick up any of the purchase order, and I will basically confirm, because that is necessary before posting a vendor invoice. And before that, you can also post a product receipt. It is up to you or as per your requirements. So I will just also post a product receipt. I will give a number to this product receipt, auto invoice. Give any number, because this is just a testing, and I will show you the lines. There are two lines. So once the product receipt is posted, then I will go to the invoice posting form, and I will submit the vendor invoice in the workflow for the approval. Once it is approved, then it will go to the pending vendor invoice, and then from there the batch job or the background process will take it on. So also you need to ensure that the batch process should be running. So here is batch management service which need to be running for this to be successful. I mean the vendor invoice posting. Okay, so now the purchase order is showing the received status, and I will go to the invoice, and I will just open the vendor invoice form. And first of all, I will perform the matching status to be passed. So I will first of all I will give the invoice a number. So based upon the whatever the purchase order is, okay, I will give a number. And then there is a posting date or invoice date. So invoice date is basically a document date from the vendor. Whenever the vendor is submitting an invoice, so that will document will have an invoice date. You need to put that here. And posting date is as per your financials, whenever you need to record that expense or inventory. So that is the date, and then due date is for the payment purpose. So once I have filled it, and I also can check the totals. I will update the match status. That is now showing pass here. I can show you the totals here. Total is this one. Okay, and then there is a workflow for the invoice approval. I will just submit it. So the vendor is the vendor invoice is submitted for the approval. Meanwhile, if I want to check it, so I can go to the accounts payable and pending vendor invoices page where the invoice will be shown, and it is showing also invoice date and last match status, and also the product receipt number. So from here you can also post it, but we are expecting that our workflow would post it, and meanwhile we can see the history of the workflow. Also you need to ensure one more thing, is that your batch job should be running for the workflow. If those are not running, you need to run the batch job. So in the inquiries of system administration, you can go to batch jobs, and from there you can just filter it down with the name of workflow. And you can see here all the jobs are shown in waiting. Just hold on until the job is run, and then we can see basically the main job is workflow message processing. So I think that has done something. So we can go to pending vendor invoices, and we can see our workflow history. So it is showing automated task started post the vendor invoice. And here you can see basically when I submitted it, please approve, and it has gone, and then there is post vendor invoice using batch, and as per its schedule it will, so it is showing that the invoice posted successfully in this number of batch. So it means this job has been completed and the invoice has been posted. So you can refresh and it will go from pending vendor invoice. And you can also go to all purchase order and check the purchase order which from which we have posted this invoice. So this one is our purchase order, and from here you can see the journal is available which is now posted. Also, there is one more thing which you can note down, and that is you can go to the system administration and go to the setup and go to process automation where our background process was, and here you can go to vendor invoice batch posting, and then you can go to view most recent results, and here you can see our results. For example, this one was our job which basically posted this invoice number successfully, so it is also shown in our execution results. So that's it for now. I think this would be helpful for few of the folks which are working in accounts department or finance department, and they are facing bulk posting of vendor invoice. They can make use of this process, and if you have any question, just let me know. Thank you very much, guys. Take care and stay tuned to my channel for the next video.